Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And after a long time, we have Anuradha ji with us again. And today we are going to discuss on Bharani Nakshatra. Amazing it is. And I'm very eager to see the slides which she has. And welcome, madam. And please enlighten us about Bharani.
Thank you, Babaji. It's a pleasure to be here on your channel once again. And Bharani Nakshatra is the nakshatra that we are going to talk about today. Before we see the slides, in transit we have the Lord of Bharani, Venus. That is the one with the planet which is given the lordship of Bharani is Venus, and it is in exaltation. So Bharani Nakshatra, as such, people who have this nakshatra in their chart are now having a good time as regards, if you have a planet in Bharani, there's definitely going to be a testing period, but definitely a good period going on for you.
And in fact, the new moon, which is there on 4th, is also in Bharani, I guess.
Yes, the Pratipada, the Amavasya is on, Ashwini, Bharani, mid.
Okay.
Pratipada is definitely starting with Bharani, but Ashwani and Bharani together are there for the new moon phase. Yes. So it is likely to bring about a lot of, things are going to take a different turn for people who have planets in Bharani. Something new will come up for them, and Venus, depending on where it is posited in their charts and where Venus is the ruler of which houses in their charts, Venus will also show its color for them because it's the starting of that month. Okay, so, Bhajit, I'd like to also add that we should not only just go by the deities. I generally speak about the deities a lot, but then all the planets posited there, Venus also will have a very strong, position for people having planets in Bharani. Where Venus is placed will give me a lot of clues. So when I'm doing my readings, I also see that. And, you can also, when we are doing this nakshatra analysis, I can also, add and show you how it is going to unfold for a person like that. So let's move on to Bharani Nakshatra. So there are three stars, okay? These three stars, 35, 39, and 41. Eretresis, Musa Bolaris, Musa Musca Bolaris, represent the tail of the ram, because it is in the house of the Aryan ram. So the face is given by Aries, the Ashwini Kumars, the Ashwini Nakshatra. It shows a horse-like face, and then the tail of the ram is signified by these three stars. Now, again, I'd like to say one thing. The Bharani Nakshatra is made up of thousands and thousands of stars, not just one star. But only those stars that are visible from the naked eye, from our surface Earth, because they would have a reflection, the stars would emit a light, and we know all forms of light affect us because they are energy. So those stars, they give their energy, they give their light to us, they energize us in a particular manner, and so are given prominence in marking the nakshatra. Otherwise, all the stars, they're made of millions of stars. Okay. So Yama is the god of death and dharma, and that is the ruling deity. The deity gives its persona to the planet, okay? And the planet, the graha or the planet, describes the event happening for a particular nakshatra. Also, as I told you earlier about the light, see, you are an engineer yourself, so you know that of the Vibhjyotir light, any color film that we put in front of a piece of paper, the piece, so you take an object and you put any color glaze paper, say green color glaze paper in front of an object. So the object, the look of the object, the color of the object as perceived by our eyes will change. So the effect of light from any of these stars, any of these nakshatras have that on us. They change our perception, they change our way of thinking, they change events around us. And if there's a planet posited, you know, superimposed on that area from where the light is coming, the planet takes in that light and it colors it with its own and reflects that light to us in a different color. So ultimately, it's the combination of the planet and the nakshatra that has a bearing on us. That's a scientific approach to it all. And how do you, because all these nakshatras have been given a deity, so they resemble certain qualities of that deity. So, and a planet, we know how it is. So, you know, when we assimilate that deity's powers, that deity's qualities with our, or with that planet, we are able to understand so much more. So, we know about Yama. The deity that we're talking about here is Yama. So in the Hindu Puranic stories, the Sanatan Dharma stories, we have Yama as one that upholds the code of social morality and rules the southern direction. So he's one of the Digpals. Digpals means one of the rulers or one of the guardians of a direction. And he's also associated with our ancestors. He was born of the son Martande and his wife Sanjana. Okay, and there's a long story about him moving into the world of the dead. So we'll be seeing that. Goddess Kali is also, she's a fierce form of Parvati, who, you know, that form of Parvati took place when she was on her rampant surge to remove, uproot evil from the world, annihilate evil, so that there can be peace for her children, because Parvati is the quintessential mother goddess. So all of us are her children. And so she wanted peace and safety, security for her children. So people who are, you know, under a lot of pressure from demonic forces or a lot of troubled times, if you worship Ma Kali for peace and for happiness and some sort of stability in your life, she definitely comes to rescue. So, and you come from one of the very strongest Shakti Peets, area of Shakti Peets, Guwahati. So you know, Kamakshi is such a strong Shakti Peet. So that she's also one form of, you know, Goddess Parvati also, Uma. So we have the Upper Bharani Shakti, the power to take things away and move on, or power to cleanse and remove impurities. So this is one of the Shaktis, okay, of the Upper Bharani Shakti. That is the inherent power that this planet, this nakshatra has, is to remove anything that is dead, or that is you know, that is an impurity that will take away impurge, jisko bolte hain, which is called to remove, impurge it of all the things that are useless and make it into something good, to remove the life from the body. Okay, is the foundation above. Foundation below is to carry the soul to the world of the ancestors, because you see, everything that you associate with the nakshatras here, be it the Shakti, be it the deity, be it the, you know, symbol, everything has a correlation. An underlying thread is running across. So when you're talking about the world of ancestors, the one deity that takes us across the Vaitarni, as we are known, as that river is known, okay, when you move from this world to the netherworld, or to the world away from the world of the humans, to the world of the soul, that you cross that with the help of Lord Yama and his Yamduts. And the desire is to be the Lord of the ancestors. So Lord Yama is also said to be the Lord of the ancestors. And you move on to the next word. So I'll just take one example here. I can take Alexander Fleming as the example, or I can also do Adolf Hitler as the example. Anyone which, but let's stick on to Alexander Fleming. We know he was a pharmacologist, and as a botanist, best and penicillin is his invention. Okay, and he won the Nobel Prize for it in 1945. He's written many articles on bacteriology, immunology, chemotherapy. What does penicillin do? It removes all that is, it is there to boost our immune system and to kill the bacteria, antibiotic. It is used as an antibiotic to clear off bacteria in our system. So it removes the impurities of unwanted life in the body and makes the body strong and going. Okay. Now see, Saturn is the Lord of the 8th house and the 9th house. So Saturn is the Lord of the 8th house of killing, death, and it is also the Lord of 8th house of transformation. 9th house Lord as Purva Punya, something that he had probably that was due for him to be done and he couldn't complete it in certain lifetime, so he had to come back and do it again. So as a 8th Lord, it makes in Bharani Nakshatra, this gives Saturn immense power. It is debilitated in Bharani Nakshatra. Yet, and it is, can you see, it is right to the exact degree, 19 degree 56 minutes of debilitation. So such people may find that they're not lucky at all. Yes, he was not lucky because he didn't know how to refine it. There were people who later on refined it and helped him how to use it. But the thing is, he was a very hard-working man. And his discoveries have been also, 8th house is the house of suddenness. And Bharani Nakshatra is also a nakshatra of suddenness. Before it achieves its balanced state, it moves into both directions. So it has takes wild swings, you know. You hear of people who are so wild in the teenager's day and age. And once they become adults, they are like upright citizens of the society kind of people. So Bharani is that star. They're very, very wild, aggressive as such when they are children. But when once they grow up, they become more and more traditional, more and more stoic, more and more towards protocol. That can be seen. Very naughty. As child, I can tell you, people who have strong Bharani Nakshatras can be very, very naughty. That is the transformation that takes place. And you see Saturn, again I say that for Adolf Hitler, it's the 7th Lord in the 7th house in Bharani Nakshatra. And he's famous for his subjugating his opponents there and then, killing them, removing life that he considered not wanted. Right? See, even Venus, retrograde 8th Lord Venus. So now let's go to Puranic stories. From there we can get many things out. So when we're talking about Puranic stories, we're talking about Surya and Sanjana, first of them, Yama and Yami. I would be doing them very strongly. And when we can also do Nachiketa. This is one of the very beautiful stories that, you can associate with. I do not remember if Nachiketa comes in Bhagavat, Babaji, but it's
yes,
a beautiful...
Yes, he's there.
He's there, right? Nachiketa is a very, very beautiful story for all of us to know. And then we know that Yama's son was... Yama was, had a child with Kunti, the eldest child of Kunti and Pandu, was a blessing of Lord Yama And he Dharmaraj, because Yama is also known as Dharmaraj, and Yudhishthir was born, and Yama also took the test of his own son Yudhishthir at many a places in Mahabharata to prove that he was deserving of the name in Savitri.
Vidur is also Yamraj only, Dhritarashtra's brother.
Right. Okay. So no wonder he's so protocolish. Vidur is always standing up to protocol and what is right and what is not. The only place he did not stand up, I think he was the only one who stood up for Draupadi's, made some attempt at stopping what was going on. Otherwise,
yeah, no, he made, and then Duryodhan said, get out of here.
So he was Vinash Kale Bipreet Buddhi for Duryodhan. So let's talk about Yama, Surya, and Sanjana. See, Yama was the son of Surya and Sanjana. Surya, Martandeh Surya. He is one of the 12 Suryas left behind by Mother Aditi, the son of Mother Aditi, to rule and to take care of this world, this solar system. Okay. Now, Surya was huge. It's the sun that we have in our solar system is 1/6 of the original sun. So, this sun was huge, as we know. Okay. And he married Vishwakarma's daughter Sanjana. And Sanjana and Surya, for a long period of time, lived happily, and they had three children, Yama, Yami, and Manu. Okay. So, but there came a time when sun's brilliance simply increased many times all over again. And as such, Sanjana felt that she could not come into the into the range of her husband's proximity. She could not come into her husband's proximity because she was too engulfed. She could not bear his heat and light. She just could not understand it. It was very, very too overpowering for her. So what she does is she at times, the way she behaves makes sun very unhappy. Then she realizes that she needs to increase her penance to increase her own tapa, her own penance, to be able to withstand her husband's light and heat. So where does she leave her children? So because she's a daughter of the celestial architect, so she also must have learned some tricks of the trade from her father. She creates her own shadow. Chaya means shadow. So from her shadow, she creates a living being. She's also a celestial being, so she does have the ability to do that. And she puts life into that shadow, and she says that, please take care of my husband and my children as your own when I am gone. She goes to her father's place. She says, I cannot live with the heat and light of sun, Surya, Martandeh. So, but her father, the father says, I'm happy to see you, but you have to return back to your husband's fold, because you are, married. So she realizes it is futile to talk to her father, try to convince him, and then she goes off in a meadow to do her penance in form of a mare. She hides herself as a mare. Now, in the meantime, there's been a long time, and Chaya has started living with sun. Okay, and she takes care. Initially, she takes good care of the three children. Sun is her husband, so she does, and three children also. But once she starts having her own children, she has one child, Shani, okay, and Tapti. These two are her children, and then there is another third child. And so these children, obviously, she's the mother, so her motherly love comes to them first, and she's totally negligent towards the other three. And it reflects badly, because a mother, no matter how many children you have, she will be equally If not, she will be equally concerned for all of them. And she may show some partiality, but not to the point that she's cruel to the other three. And one day when Yama starts thinking on those grounds, and one day when he sees Sanjana being very, very, Chaya being very rude to Yami and Manu, he actually goes and kicks her and says, "Are you truly a mother?" And Chaya gets angry and curses him that may your feet fall off. Now, when he's cursed, Yama runs to his father and says, "I'm sure she's not my mother, because no mother can curse a child." Then Surya, he does something, and by that time, may your feet fall, she says actually. So by that time, the maggots start infecting his feet, Yama's feet. And then Surya does something, he also to stop the maggots from, you know, going further. So here is one remedial measure. I'm making a stop here and telling you, if you have problem with your feet or if you have issues from mother, the best kind of, you know, thing that you can do is please the sun god. Okay, give the Surya Rak and things like that. So what he does is, Surya does that, he gets her back, he sends you know, Yama, he consoles Yama, tends to Yama, and then he rushes to Chaya and says, "You are an imposter." And he says, "I tell me, otherwise I'll curse you." No, she's very afraid. She's also told Sanjana that, "I will, if at any point your husband tries to find the truth from me, then I will definitely let him know. Otherwise, I'll hide." So she says, she does the entire story. Now, son goes to Vishwakarma and says that, "Tell us, please let me know where Sanjana is." So he says, "No, I sent her back packing to you." So he says that, "No, she did not come." So being the one of the mediators, Vishwakarma says that, "See, she was overpowered by your brilliance. So to have a happy conjugal life, why do you not tone it down?" Now Vishwakarma is the deity of the seventh, of Chitra Nakshatra, okay, which falls in the seventh house. Two pada of it fall in the seventh house of the natural zodiac, okay, and that is the seventh house is where sun gets debilitated. So again, one thing is, if you want a happy married life, get your ego, because today the soul is not that active, the ego is. Get your ego down. Sun is also a reflection of your ego. Get your ego down if you want a happy married life. Okay? Because it is the sun gets debilitated in the seventh house. Okay? Now sun gets going to find the, his mate, his wife, Sanjana, and he sees that Sanjana is there in a form of a mare in a garden. And seeing sun, she's celestial, she recognizes her husband as a stallion. He rushes and he gets her. We've done this story in Ashwini Kumar's. They come back, they lead a happy married life. But the key point here that I'm trying to make is, there's a loss of mother for some time, no matter how brief. And the stepmotherly treatment from a mother figure can be seen, or unfairness can be observed. They can be also, if it's good, if the Bharani Nakshatra is good here, then there can be a mother figure who brings you up, whom you can associate with. There will definitely be a disturbance in the married life of the pair. And mother can have a twin or a sister very close to her, and there can be problem with feet. So when we are fighting for justice here, so you are fighting for justice also. Okay, because you see, we also saw that he was the one who was fighting, Yamraj was the one who was fighting for justice, Dharmraj. He was the one who told Chaya that, "You're not my mother. This is not the way you treat the children around you." So we know Martin King Luther, he has his ascendant in Bharani Nakshatra. We know that he was fighting for a cause of equality for the blacks. Okay, and he says that he has, I have a dream, that the speech is legendary there. Okay, and said to be one of the greatest orators and influencers of the last century. And see, like I was telling you, where does this, the Lord of this Nakshatra go and sit? It goes and sits in the 11th house. 11th house is the house of big gatherings. 11th house is the house of games. It is sitting with the fourth Lord, Moon, the masses. So he had huge amount of games. He had a huge amount of fan following, people who are listening to him. At the same time, you see, it's the second Lord.
Yes.
Okay. And it is also the seventh Lord. Okay. So it's sitting in the 11th house. Seventh Lord is opposition. Seventh Lord is your open enemy. So he did have people who were absolutely against him. He was killed. He was shot in a crowd by somebody from the crowd. Second house is also Markesh. Second and seventh house is also Markesh. And he was killed in the masses. So nakshatra analysis is beautiful from a number of point of views. It gives you a character base. It also gives you an event base. A native has fourth Lord in Bharani. His mother has an ankle accident on road decades, but it is not healed. So anybody. So if people might have their fourth, any planet in the fourth house in Bharani for Capricorn Lagna can show that mother can have issues with that body part of hers, especially the legs. Lot of problem with feet can be seen, left wrist can be seen, lot of that. Anna Roosevelt. She's the daughter of Franklin and Eleanor Roosevelt. Okay. And politically, it was a very, very, FDR was a very, very famous, one of the most famous after George Washington and, Abraham Lincoln. FDR was supposed to be one of the very famous presidents. And her father, if you see, son is her Lagna Lord, and son is sitting in the 10th house of father. Okay, and son here is though exalted son, but her father had polio and her father was, not able to walk properly. And you can see that. And when you see the Lord of this Nakshatra son is in the 9th house of father. Okay, and son, the Lord of this Nakshatra has gone in the 10th house, the second house from the house of the father. So, what do you see? You see that the father was also a very rich person because Venus is sitting in its own house. If I take 9th house for being a father, I take the Lagna of the father, Venus sitting in its own house in Taurus gives father huge amount of riches. Okay. And it's sitting with Jupiter and Mars. So immense popularity also for the father.